My name is Raya.
So, what did you think about that?
I hated it.
I mean, same.
I mean, look at it. Look at where is the woven patterns. I mean, if you're gonna make a movie about Southeast Asia, why don't you, I don't know, research about Southeast Asia? It's already bad enough that you're forcing us into one category when we're such a diverse region, you know? It's so... why am I even surprised with Disney at this point?
Okay. I think we should take our minds off from whatever this thing is and focus on another film that deserves our attention. Something a little more, you know, recent, just came out on Netflix the other day.
You mean 2020 computer animated musical adventure comedy drama film Over the Moon?
You mean 2020 computer animated musical adventure comedy drama film Over the Moon, directed by animation legend Glen Keane?
You mean American animator, author, and illustrator, animation legend Glen Keane?
You mean animation legend Glen...
Glen Keane was born in April 13, 1954, in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. He is the son of cartoonist Bill Keane, the creator of the comic strip The Family Circus. In fact, this character, Billy, is based on Glen himself. Glen's father was a big influence for him growing up. His father even gave him an anatomy book when he was 9 years old and encouraged him to study art. In 1972, he went to CalArts to submit his portfolio to the School of Painting, but his portfolio somehow ended up in Jules Engel's School of Film Graphics, now known as the School of Experimental Animation, and he got accepted, despite not knowing who Jules Engel was or what film graphic meant. He eventually fell in love with animation, saying, "I realized that if Michelangelo, Rodin, or Degas was alive today, they would want to be animators." Glen Keane is also considered a successor of Disney's Nine Old Men, or the original artists in Disney, having learned about storytelling, drawing, and design directly from them. Glen Keane worked as a layout artist for a few filmation works before leaving CalArts and joining Disney in 1974. To cut his extremely long stay in Disney short, here are some of his most prominent works and achievements from his almost 40-year career with Disney. He worked with John Lasseter, the future director of Toy Story, in 1982 to create a 30-second test scene inspired by Where the Wild Things Are, which mixed traditional and computer animation. This was revolutionary and became the predecessor for the iconic ballroom scene in Beauty and the Beast. He worked on countless Disney films as a supervising animator for films like The Fox and the Hound, The Great Mouse Detective, The Little Mermaid, Beauty and the Beast, Aladdin, Pocahontas, Tarzan, and Treasure Planet, or as a character designer for Oliver and Company, The Little Mermaid, Pocahontas, and Tangled. His design for Ariel became the start of the iconic Disney princess face. In other words, a heart-shaped face, large and round eyes, a button nose, and a small mouth. Out of the three Disney princesses that he designed, Pocahontas was the only woman of color. Pocahontas' design, just like the rest of the movie, is rather controversial and has been criticized for appearing much more sexual than the other female characters Glen Keane has designed. And unfortunately, this issue has never been addressed by Disney or Keane himself.
In 2012, after 37 years of working at Disney, Glen Keane left the company, saying, "I am convinced that animation really is the ultimate form of our time, with endless new territories to explore. I can't resist its siren's call to step out and discover them." He sought to expand his horizons on the animation medium, and saw his decision to leave as a means of doing so. He continues to do animation work to this day, and made his feature directorial debut in 2020 with the film Over the Moon, which is an American-Chinese animated musical, which also happens to be the film that you should be focusing on rather than giving all your focus on Disney, because there are other more worthy studios capable of representing culture which Disney clearly cannot do. Glen Keane continues to leave a mark on the world of animation as a whole. Even years after his leave, his princess face art style from his work as a character designer has come to be known as Disney's most notable stylistic choices for female protagonists across their films. A vast majority of characters in fiction could be easily be recognized as a product of Disney because of the style in question. While not directly designed from him, characters from the most recent Disney films continue to share the similar design choice, as seen through Elsa and Anna from Frozen 2, and the princess characters featured in Ralph Breaks the Internet.
Hi!
Glen is also considered as an inspiration and role model for many of those within the animation world. He actively took on a mentoring role within the industry, hoping to pass on his knowledge and skill of classical animation to the newer generation of artists for the years to come. Rather than focusing solely on the technical aspects of animation, he made it a priority to teach fellow animators about the aspect of breathing life into characters and making them beyond moving figures on the screen. His former colleagues, senior animators at Walt Disney Studios with Oscar awards under the name, describe him as a master, a teacher, a mentor, and a friend to the entire animation community. Along with this, he had also hoped to share with his audience the old-fashioned magic of traditional animation while acknowledging the capabilities of newer technology, showing how the both of them can go hand-in-hand amidst the changing times of the animation industry. This is manifested through his 2014 film Duet, which is traditionally animated yet viewable through interactive digital camera lenses provided by Google, and could also be seen in his most recent film Over the Moon, with its mix of hand-drawn and 3D animation. Glen Keane is often regarded as a legend within the animation world, and rightfully so. From his early marks on some of Disney's greatest classic films, to his most recent pursuits of enriching the animation medium with unique designs and film direction, Glen consciously makes an effort to reach out to all of us as students and enthusiasts for animation, reminding us to always believe in our character and to animate with sincerity.